dim break command lets us break parts of dimension lines and extension lines where they cross over each other and over other entities. In this video, I'm going to show you how that works. I'm going to enter in the dim break command, press enter. We can see right here there's a problem. So on the command prompt, it asks me select the dimension, and I'm going to want to break this one, and then it says select object to break dimension, and I'll select the other dimension, and instantly there's a gap around the 5 now. That's bad dimensioning practice to have the 5 right in the extension line like that, but I put that there for illustrative purposes. It also works with entities, so let's repeat the dim break command. I want this dimension line, in this case a leader, broken, and then it asks me which object. I select this polyline, and again you have that break there. And I'm going to do it one more time down here. Select the dimension, select the one to do the break. Now you can remove the breaks in all dimension lines at once or individually. Let me show you how to do it all at once. I enter in the dim break command and then type M for the multiple option. And it's going to ask me which dimensions I want to add or remove the break. Well, I can type in all to select all. And notice that BricsCAD only selects dimensions. Then I press enter one more time to indicate I'm done selecting entities. And then it has the options. I can break dimensions or else remove. Type an R for remove. I'm going to type R for remove, and it's done. And you can see that all the dimension lines and extension lines are healed. The third option in DimBreak is automatic. It breaks dimension lines automatically, but only under one condition. Let me show you how. I've entered the DimBreak command. I've entered in M for multiple dimension lines. Type all for all. Press enter to continue. And you can see down there is the auto option. Type A for auto and press enter. Let's see what's happened. Well, the only dim line to break is right here by the polyline. The other ones that cross over did not break. And there's a reason for that. BricsCAD doesn't know which one you want to break, which dimension line, and so it leaves them alone.